If you were going to tell somebody to pinstripe them, now listen close, bud, this one here. Would you tell them to practice your straight lines, maybe start out with flames before you start out with designs?
Yes.
Get all your straight lines and start on curves, right?
Right. The reason being is it's a flame job is laid out there for you.
Right. It's like you're following it.
Right. And it's just a matter of practice and covering two colors meet. You know, just to get a feel for it.
Right.
The more you work with a flames and stuff like that, in my opinion, I think it's going to develop.
Okay, now, let's say that you really don't know how to draw a pinstripe design. You were saying something about warlock pins. What was that? Old school 50s with had more points than the stylish stuff.
Well, there's different types of pinstripe. Dad did more of the curves.
Yeah, he did more stylish, elegant.
Right. And Von Dutch,
he does
style
the,
is more...
Right, 50s hardcore, rat rod, pointed
hard edge, look. You know, a lot of... geometric shapes.
Yeah.
Dad's style was more organic. A lot of curves.
Uh-huh. Right, right. Now your style, I mean, we're just using these as an example. You'd like the Von Dutch 50s rat rod look better.
Right.
Okay. Now let me ask you this, but let's say a guy is watching this video and he says, I'm watching it because I want to learn how to pinstripe.
Okay.
But I don't know how to start these designs out. I don't know, what am I going to do? Would you suggest to him, now this is before he goes and wastes paint and all this other shit, to practice drawing up designs with a pencil and just keep drawing them to get used to them? Or
yes.
You would tell him to do that before he started pinstriping shit?
Well,
not for money, I'm just saying for practice, bud.
Right, just, I mean, it's kind of an exercise and imagination.
Yeah. Okay, let me ask you this.
That way you're not just walking right up with a paintbrush and looking at basically like a blank piece of
blank. Like, because most of the time when you do this, you try to learn how to do it, your mind becomes blank.
Right.
Because you try to be different than everybody else. You don't want to copy somebody. Like somebody else we know, we don't want to mention the name.
Well, if you've got...
Not you, dude.
If you've got your... Say, for instance, you walk up...
Uh-huh.
And you really don't have a set game plan, any kind of design in your mind.
Right.
It's very easy to overdo it. You can almost over add too much.
Right, right. Yes, I agree with you 100% on that. Sometimes too much is too much.
Now that's just my own experience.
Oh, I know, dude.
I'm not an expert, an authority on it, or anything.
Oh, I agree with you 100%. Sometimes it just gets so fucking gaudy.
Right.
Like me and your dad had to talk one time about airbrushing. Yeah, airbrushing is some of these airbrushers, they're badass, dude. There's no fucking way I can do that shit. But then on the other hand, some of it just, and I love airbrush work. I mean, to look at it and say, man, look what this guy did. But to me, some of it is just so gaudy that you just don't, it's just too much, dude.
Well, it's easy to get carried away.
Yeah. But I'm not cutting it down.
And I'm just as guilty of it. I mean, I think everybody goes through that.
Yeah, everybody does, even me.
You know,
look at our 41 Willys, I pinstripe that, you know, a little bit too much, but that's why you're finishing it out, dude. You're gonna finish it out for me, right?
You bet.
Thank you very much. I'm gonna go to sleep thinking about it. I don't have to think about the Willys tonight. Okay, now, so, would you suggest this, dude? This is the last question I'm gonna ask for a beginner guy that might want to learn how to do this. Would you suggest that this might be a good idea? Of course, positive attitude always gets you far, am I right?
Right.
Because if you don't have a positive attitude, you ain't gonna fucking be able to do it. Now, where am I looking from? You ain't gonna be able to do it, am I right?
Well, I would say your two biggest things that are gonna help you most are patience.
And attitude.
And attitude, and it's gonna lead to your confidence being built.
Yeah.
The more you do it, the more comfortable you'll be.
It's like anything else. Practice makes perfect.
Right. And your confidence, I mean, don't concentrate so much on the speed from the, at the beginning, but the accuracy, the speed will come to you later.
Okay, this is our last question. Would you suggest, now this is just something I'm gonna throw at you, pop up. Would you suggest to take a piece of glass like you said to practice on, because that does make sense, and maybe take a pencil, because I've seen you do this before, dude. I've seen you draw pictures and you use those as a template to paint them in. Would you go ahead and draw the design out that you want to do, right? Basically, you know, draw a pinstripe design. And then can you come back, that's just for practice, come back and paint it?
Yes.
That would be a good way to actually teach yourself.
I've done that too.
You have?
Well, a lot of people don't understand. I mean, well, a lot of people do understand. I'm still in the learning process of this.
But you got more experience than most of us out there.
Well, I've been fortunate enough. I've been exposed to it a lot longer than everybody else has because of Dad was doing it for so many years.
Right. Wow.
But actually hands-on, I'm still basically in a beginner stage. That's as honest as I can be as far as
maybe for pinstriping, but not for car artwork that you do.
Well,
you're pretty got that down like science, but
then it's still a learning process.
Right.
I mean, the more you do it, the more you learn.
I see what you're saying, dude.
I mean, I've been fortunate enough to learn something every time I pick the brush up.
Exactly. Well, you know, I've dipped my hand in it a few times, you know. Yeah, I'll tell you something else.
I've tried at least once.
Well, I've tried a few times. I just don't have the patience. That's another thing. You really, really, to pinstriping, dude, I'm going to tell you right now, and believe me, you have to have patience for it. You can't just think you're going to do it. That's a very tedious job that he's doing. Don't think that it isn't. Because when you do a job like this, bud, it's like your body tenses up. When you first start out doing something like this, I mean, it's a tedious freak. Especially on something like this with uneven level. Look at all the uneven surface you're doing it on. That's kind of like doing it on a fucking boulder in Colorado, a rock, dude. I'm serious, huh? I didn't think about that. Look at all the, you know what I'm saying? Look at the way that you got, that's not even a flat surface, dude.
It's got different textures to it.
Yeah, so that would actually be hard for somebody to do. Now, one more thing. When you pinstripe something, color choice really, really matters a lot.
Yes.
So,
what you want to try to do is you'll experiment with the colors. Don't be afraid to put a little bit on there.
Right.
And wipe it off just to see which colors complement the others.
Now, hold on. You're using one-shot paint, which that's pretty much the industry number one shit to use.
It's a matter of personal preference.
A lot of people use. Yeah, some people use House of Color. Okay.
One shot is very forgiving.
Yeah.
It's very easy to work with. To me, it lives up to its name. It covers one shot.
But the problem with it is you cannot touch it for 24 hours. You have to be very, very careful in weather like this.
Exactly.
And if you're going to clear coat over it, you better fucking be careful because the pinstriper will charge you extra to come back and fix it if it blisters because you don't know how to lay the clear on that.
Yeah. And laying the clear is very tricky.
That's right.
The man operating the camera knows how to clear.
Yeah, we've had your dad come back several times with that. Now, okay, dude, we're going to come back and talk to Jimmy again about his design when he gets ready to put the design on. And, Jimmy, I think you're going to be surprised how many people actually look at this video and leave you, Jimmy Crawford Jr., comments on Instagram.
Too cool.
Now, where's my dog at? There you go. Bruno. I know it's laid out. I know it's getting dark. Let's see. Is it?
Get a little impatient.
Don't get impatient, bud. I know you're hungry. We're not going in yet.